For your SST also, we will start a new lesson. That is on your lesson number 14, the birth of the United Nations. So here we are going to learn how the UNO also formed, okay? Okay, the nature of human beings all over the world is almost same, but their lives are very much different. Some people live in developed countries. They are rich, they live better, they can get everything they want. Some people live in poor, underdeveloped countries. They do not get even a square meal. Millions of people die of hunger and sickness. Due to industrialization, the production in the developed country increased. They had to look out for new markets for their products and for raw materials. Therefore, the race for colonization started. Okay, so here what it says, even all over the world, the nature of human beings are almost same. That means all over the world, especially with the human being, we all eat, we all wear clothes, we all work, we walk, we talk. So these are the natures that we are same. But, and the way we live also, same, but in this, the comparison is some are rich and some are poor. So this is the difference, okay? In developed countries, people live a better life. Why? Because they are rich, okay? They are well educated and they get whatever they want. If they want to eat, they get whatever they need, they get. So they live in a better life as a developed country. But some are in a very poor condition till now, okay? And those are underdeveloped countries because they do not have a square meal, okay? Even for a day, for the whole day also, some are suffering from hungerness, okay? Millions of people die. This is because of hungerness and because of due to the sickness. And so due to the industrializations, okay, there are so many things different between the developed and undeveloped countries, all right? So underdeveloped countries, people, they don't need to go from far place to place, okay, in search of things and all for food and all. But under undeveloped countries, people had to go in the far places, in the market and all, to search the product, that also, which are cheap and all, okay, raw materials and all this includes about the fooding and all right? So they suffer, and because of this, colonization, it started, okay? This gave rise to jealousy and hatred among the nations, which often resulted in wars. So this is how war happened. Because of jealousy, some becoming rich and well developed, some are not. Because of this, by seeing the goodness, the richness between the people, jealousy started, and hatred means started forming an enemy, okay? So this started. The early part of the 20th century witnessed two very big wars. Most of the countries of the world were involved in these wars. Thus, these wars are called the World War. So we all heard about two war, that is First World War and Second World War, okay? Why the war also happened? This is all because of the lack of developing countries, okay? Because of the rich and poor, okay? Because of all the conditions, all the backward condition, the war has brought up, all right? The First World War was fought from, keep in mind this, underline this, okay? First World War was fought from 1914 to 1918. Till 1918, First World War fought, okay? And the Second World War was fought from 1939 to 1945. Till here, the Second World War, it fought, okay? Underline all this. Both the war started in Europe and spread to other countries. So different countries fought in this World War, all right? And it was started in the Europe, and after that spread to another countries. Millions of people died and much property was destroyed in these two war. The Second World War proved to be more fierce and destructive than the First World War. It ended in 1945 when the USA dropped atom bombs on two Japanese cities, Nagasaki and Hiroshima. Underline these two cities. These two cities are very important, okay? You have to know this, keep in mind. Here it says that the Second World War was, it proved and it says to be more fierce, means more danger, okay? Comparing the First World War, all right? People fought in this war destructive than the First World War means they destroy more places, more people comparing the First World War. Lots of thousand million people died. Okay, it was uncountable. Cannot count how many people have died in this war. Okay, but it ended in 1945. How? This is true. By the USA, okay, they drop an atom bomb. This atom bomb is one of the most fierce and most dangerous bombs, okay, bomb. And they drop this bomb in two cities in Japanese, that is Nagasaki and Hiroshima, okay. After they drop down this, everything was shut down properly. They destroyed so many teams, but with this, the war ended, okay. Only this much we will do today. The rest we will continue in our next class. So listen to the explanation audio carefully. 2-3 times you have to listen, all right. That's all.